the unique topic, what we call ADHD, the acronym Attention Deficit Hyperactivity Disorder. And if the time permits, the second topic which he has given me, asked to speak on, is ODD, that is again Oppositional and Defiant Disorder. ADHD is chanchal bachche, jo ek jagah pe baith nahi sakte hain, and ODD is ziddi bachche, jo kisi ki sunte nahi. So these are the two common topics. As he mentioned that in Sion Hospital we have LD clinic, Learning Disorder Clinic, and students from all over Bombay are referred to our pediatric department, which is having this Learning Disorder Clinic. And whenever they find that along with LD, learning disorder, the students also have behavior problem, these students are referred to psychiatry department. We have child and adolescent guidance clinic. So we, these kind of children. The most common behavior problem which we see in these children is ADHD. In general population, you have, might have around 5% of the children who have ADHD. But if you have LD, then that frequency increases to 20%. Means almost 1 in 5 children who have LD also have concomitant ADHD. So that's why we thought it might be a good idea to share our clinical experience. Because I see these children in my clinic, you see in them, you see them in your school, we see them in our neighborhood, on the road, all over around us. So if we share our experience with each other, I think it would be mutually beneficial and useful to all of us. So let me start with these two, three cases of ADHD which had come to our clinic. Beena, she was in 4th standard and she was brought by her parents with the complaints that she makes silly mistakes. I think all of you have this heard this word called silly mistakes. So I asked, what exactly do you mean by silly mistakes? The mother said that suppose the first sum is addition, second is addition, say 3 plus 4, she will write 7. Second, 9 plus 4, she will write 13. She is good at her maths. The third sum is 9 minus 4, she will write 13. First was addition, second was addition, now shift of attention does not occur. And third sum also she writes, and you say, Beena, look, the set. Oh, sorry. I didn't see it's minus. 9 minus 4 is 5. She knows. But because first and second sums were addition, these are called silly mistakes, that actually she knows her maths, but still she will lose her marks in the exam. And that's why these children need constant supervision in the class, that whether they are doing the work properly or not. Many parents say because they are short attention span, they don't remember things and tend to lose things frequently. Nowadays, even adults lose things frequently. I have a friend who has lost his 3 mobile phones in last probably 1 year. I keep my mobile phone in the pocket. Whenever somebody calls, I talk to it, I keep it back in my pocket. He says that he uses very high-end phone, iPhone 10 plus kind of thing. So he says, if I keep it in my pocket, who will see it? So he wants to keep it in his hand and flash it around, showing everyone that, see, I am using this phone. And then he also has this problem with attention concentration. So he'll get into a rickshaw, put the phone next to him, he'll reach his destination, he'll make a payment and then walk down. The phone remains behind in the rickshaw. Obviously, rickshaw walas, taxi walas will be very, very happy with these kind of customers who leave things behind, and particularly iPhones. Only thing, the same thing happens in children. The things which are not part of our body, we tend to lose. And we had this child, our parents brought, and the mother was very, very tense, because he used to lose things frequently. Children also tend to lose things frequently. Like in monsoon, all of us carry umbrella, and if it's not raining, we go out and lose our umbrella behind. Similarly, sometimes children lose pencil, eraser, compass box. And the most frequently lost item is water bottles.
We are watching
because
the
water bottles are
speech
not part of the bag and many
the demonstration
carry the water bottles.
Dr. Nilesh Shah.
So this mother said that I get a lot of tension, a lot of tension. What happened? They had gone to Europe and they had brought a very very fancy water bottle. Very very colorful water bottle, and then if you press one button some music will come and another button and that straw will come, and very fancy, a unique kind of water bottle for which they had spent 20 euros, which is around 1500 rupees for a water bottle. And this boy was very very happy, saying, oh, nobody in the school has this water bottle. I am the only person who has this water bottle. By the end of first week he managed to lose this water. And the parents were mad. मैं स्कूल बस में गया तो थी, फिर मेरे दोस्त ने ली, उसको उसको भाई को दिखानी थी, किधर गई, कहाँ गई, गई. They went everywhere. They could not find the water bottle. So mother said that we can't trust him with this expensive things. So they started giving him water in a simple water bottle which is available on the roadside for 10-20 rupees. He would lose those water bottles also. And then mother came and said, मुझे बहुत टेंशन आता है, पैसे की इतनी कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, बट वो भूल क्यों जाता है? और उसके कारण मेरा तनाव इतना बढ़ गया है कि जैसे ही शाम को 4 बजते हैं, मैं स्कूल बस वापस आने वाली है, मैं नीचे खड़ी हूँ, सब लोग खड़े हैं, और जैसे ही स्कूल बस आती है तो मेरा टेंशन बढ़ता है, धीरे धीरे बढ़ता है, धीरे धीरे बढ़ता है. और दूसरे बच्चे जब उतरते हैं स्कूल बस से तो मदर्स पूछती है उनको, How was your day? What did you do in school? आज कुछ homework दिया है वगैरह. And I, as soon as I see him, I ask him, where is your water bottle? अगर water bottle है, तो मेरा तनाव कम हो जाता है. Good boy, brought water bottle, come. और अगर बोलता है, हाँ, bag में रखी तो थी पर, फिर I lose my temper, I shout, I scream. And so, मेरा तनाव बहुत ज्यादा है, तो मैंने क्या किया अभी टेंशन कम करने के लिए, आई डोंट गिव हिम वाटर बॉटल, आई गिव हिम वाटर इन प्लास्टिक बैग विद अ क्लिप एंड अ स्ट्रॉ. और आई हैव टोल्ड हिम, यू ड्रिंक वाटर फ्रॉम दिस, बट वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, यू डोंट हैव टू ब्रिंग इट बैक. वेदर यू रन आउट ऑफ वाटर, वेदर यू हैव वाटर, जस्ट आफ्टर एट द एंड ऑफ द डे थ्रो इट इन द डस्टबिन एंड कम होम. सो मेरे को तनाव नहीं चाहिए, नो टेंशन. So we have these children who have what we call attention deficit disorder. That means they have a short attention span. The normal attention span for adults is also 20 minutes. So ideally no lectures should be more than 20 minutes. But then it's not possible. We have to have full day of school, and that's why all of us need to have little more attention. So what generally we ask the teacher, how is his attention as compared to other children of his class or other children of his age? If his attention is substantially less than the other children of his class or other children of his age, then we call it a short attention span. So the first and foremost is that child has short attention span, and second, easy distractibility. He gets easily distracted. Suppose there is some noise, we will notice that noise, but we won't get distracted. But he will get up and run and go and see what is happening outside. Yeah. So they have easy distractibility. If you have only attention problem, they don't end up disturbing the class. They are quite nice. They are sitting, they are watching, they will pay attention for 5 minutes, 10 minutes, and after that they start daydreaming. They start thinking, आज शाम को क्या करना है, आज बाद में कल क्या होना है, छुट्टी में क्या करेंगे, क्या खाना खाएंगे, क्या पियेंगे, वगैरह वगैरह. So they look as if they are attending to the teacher, but they are in their own world, they are daydreaming. In computer terminology, it is called they go into screen saver mode. So if you keep the computer on and after a while the computer goes on a screen saver mode, similarly they also go into a screen saver mode. So we require to help these children, because if they are not attentive in the class, they lag behind in studies. And though they are intelligent, they make silly mistakes and get less marks. In Sion Hospital where I practice, we ask all the children their wish. आप बड़े हो जाओगे तो क्या बनना चाहोगे? We asked Veena also, okay, what would you like to be? Any idea what she wants to be? Yes. She wants to be a school teacher and maths teacher. She has short attention span. She is, instead of plus, she is doing minus, multiplication, division, but she is going to become a school teacher. We had another child, Elvis. Elvis was brought to us with the complaints that he is unable to sit at one place in the class. Many teachers have told me that this is the most irritating symptom in the class. I still remember one teacher telling me about a girl in her class called Rani. She says, "Doctor, I'm so tired of this girl. Rani is sitting here." And I said, "Rani, say, look, we have to write decimal and she will get up and go and sit here. Rani, why did you change your place?" I couldn't see. "Okay. Now sit there and look." And she gets up and goes and sits there. She thinks they are playing a musical chair. As soon as teacher turns, you have to change the place. She says she's so irritating, and every time I ask her, "Why did you change the place?" she has some excuse, she has some reason. And suddenly in the middle of the class, she will get up, she will loiter around, she will go out of the class, go and drink water again, come back. No discipline. So they are unable to sit at one place in the class. They are very talkative and noisy. And that's why they end up disturbing the class. Teacher is sitting in the middle of the class, they will start talking among themselves and it will disturb the class. They are also clumsy. So while walking, they will trip, they will fall, they will drop something, and also mischievous. So not only they fall, but when they are sitting and somebody is walking, they will put their foot in between. So other person trips and then everybody has a big laugh about how he did it, or they throw chalk at somebody or paper ball at somebody, kind of thing. And again, they can't wait for turn. Many of us have seen this Kaun Banega Karodpati. And in that, you have this fastest finger first. So you have to be first. So I think they get encouraged by that. They take inspiration from there. So when the teacher says, "Let me ask you one question." "Ah, me. But even I have not asked the question. But even before that, they want to raise their hand and they want to be first every time. Assembly bell, they want to be first. Anything and everything, they cannot wait for their turn. In fact, because of that, there are lots of problems. We had this parents, they had a family game. You know, we have our national game. What is our national game?
Kabaddi.
Our national game is hockey. Kabaddi is only in parliament. The most popular game is cricket. And this family had a popular game, their family game, which was carom board. The father was a carom champion, national carom champion. Mother was a state level carom champion. The daughter was an inter-school carom champion. And this kiddo was ADHD. So every evening there will be fights, because he said, I also want to play with the family. So they will all sit and say, "I'll be first." So he'll break the board. Thak. Then the father, national champion, thak, 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 thak. Half of the board is over. Mother, thak, 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 thak. So every time he will break the board and then thak, 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 very low. And obviously, they'll be very, very unhappy, very, very crying, temper tantrums. And they came, "What should we do?" They will tell him, "Go and play with other children, go to neighbors, go to cousins." He says, "Nahin, mujhe aapke saath hi khelna." So I said, "What can be done?" So usually, we do not recommend anything. As the counselors, you know, I understand your problem, what can be done, what options do we have. So like that, we kind of talk to them. And then that boy suggested that he wants more number of turns. And that's why they said, "Okay, we will start playing game with a different rule." The different rule was that boy will break the board first, then the father will play, but then he will have only one turn. whether he puts the coin in or not, but still he will have one turn. Then again the boy will play. Then one turn for mother, then again the boy will play. One turn for sister, again the boy will play. So when other three people get one turn, he will get four turns. As a psychiatrist, as a counselor, as a therapist, we are a little critical about this, that we encourage to follow the discipline. We encourage children that they should play the game by the rules and not the way they want to play. It's a question of a little bit discipline, that game hai to rules se khelenge. But here we said, okay, they have developed this strategy, try it out for a month and get back to us how you are doing. They came back after 1 month. And I said, how are you doing? This is wonderful. I said, haven't we spoiled him? He says, not at all. Because now he's getting many turns, he is happy. And now we have seen his skills have improved like anything. And I said, what happens when he plays with his friends? He says, what generosity we have shown, what leniency we have shown, the same generosity, same leniency he is showing with the other children. So there he takes up the role of the parent and he says, chalo, because he is the best, he is playing every day. So he teaches other children, aap aise khelo, aap yahan se lo. Aur acha, aap do turn lo, main khali ek turn lunga. So what parents did to him, he has picked up that. And now he is very well and his skills have improved and his behavior problem also has improved. So these are all kinds of practical solutions, because we do not have easy answers for any one situation. Each situation is different, each child is different, each parents are different. So one of the things which we recommend, that we will have to be innovative, found some new ideas. Find some new ideas for dealing with this kind of situation. Try one strategy, if it works well and good. If it doesn't work, shift your gears, try another strategy. Elvis, who cannot sit at one place for even 2 minutes, we asked him also, what would you like to be when you are grown up? Any idea what Elvis wants to be?
Pilot?
Yes, perfect. He wants to be a pilot. I said, see, shortest flight from Bombay to Pune is also 40 minutes.
Yes,
I am never ever going to fly with you, because the flight takes off and after 5-10 minutes you come back and say, hello, how are you, passengers? We will miss our heartbeats. Who's there in front? Diagnosis of ADHD is very, very easy. We don't have to ask any question, any history, any examination, nothing. I am sitting in my clinic and most of the children are scared of the doctors, because bachpan se unko daraya gaya hai, masti karega to itna bada injection de denge. Kisi ne dekha itna bada injection? Nahi. Par bachpan se unko darate hain, bada injection. So all the children are scared, aur doctor ke paas jana yani pehle hi rona chalo. So most of the children sitting in the clinic, when the turn comes, the parents say, nahi, ye achhe doctor hai, ye injection wale nahi hai, ye aisa nahi karenge. And they walk in and they had to kind of drag their child behind, samjhane ka keh rahe, ye achhe doctor. When there is the ADHD child, it is other way around. We are sitting in our clinic and we see somebody is running in the clinic, somebody is waiting room, somebody is jumping and parents are reprimanding. Arey udhar mat chado, arey usko haath mat lagao, arey wo fat jayega, arey ye gir jayega, kind of thing. And when their turn comes, he is the first to walk in and the parents are dragged behind saying, well, thero, jate hai, jaldi mat kar. So he walks in and then they cannot keep their hands to self. So immediately they want to touch everything, whatever is on the table. So they are very fancy about the call bell, which is there to call the ward boy. So he comes inside, starts picking up and starts ringing the bell. Ting, 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 ting. And ward boy, who is somewhere else, he hears this ting, 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 immediately comes. And then he realizes it's not me who is calling him, but this boy is just playing with the call bell. So he says, अच्छा अच्छा मुलगा वाजवतो का, ADHD आहे. I don't have to make any diagnosis. Diagnosis is made. I look at the parents, I smile at them, they smile at me. We have understood what the problem is. If you are trying to work with these children, it's very, very difficult. If you try to ask them, beta, aapka naam kya hai? Not interested. Beta, aap kaun si school mein jaate ho? Not interested. Before you ask any question, this boy came in, and before I could ask any question, he says, ab doctor ho? Because as a psychiatrist, we don't wear those stethoscope and deep instruments and that ENT people and often people which they wear. So he was surprised to see us just like an ordinary person, ab doctor ho? So then you feel a little bad, kare. So you say, haan haan, main bhi doctor hoon. Achha, ab doctor ho? Tell me, what is scoliosis fracture? So I am totally stumped, ab scoliosis fracture? So I start scratching my coconut and say, are scoliosis fracture? Nahi pata hai, toh na bolo na. I said, aapko pata hai? हाँ मुझे पता है. देखो यहाँ जो फ्रैक्चर होता है और ऐसे गिरते हैं तभी जो होता है उसे कोलिसिस फ्रैक्चर कहते हैं. फिर एक्सरे में ऐसा दिखता है, फिर ऐसा प्लास्टर लगाना पड़ता है, 6 हफ्ते तक हाथ ऐसा रखना पड़ता है, एक्सरसाइज भी करनी पड़ती है, फिर ठीक हो जाता है. आई सेड वाओ, यू नो अबाउट कोलिसिस फ्रैक्चर, नाउ आई रिमेम्बर, यस यस, दिस इज कोलिसिस फ्रैक्चर. अच्छा, व्हाट इज पॉट्स फ्रैक्चर? ही न्यू अबाउट 6 different fractures. They are accident prone. I asked the father, how come he knows about 6 different fractures? He said he had it.
Experience.
Ye ek jagah baithta nahi hai. I had another patient. They went to Lonawala in their bungalow. He went on the first floor and stood like this. I am a superman. And then from first floor and sustained multiple fractures. But then they don't realize that what would be the consequences of their behavior on self or the other. So they are all accident prone, and luckily for the father, father's brother was orthopedic surgeon. So every time he will have a fall, it will be taken, and they are very lovable children. Where everybody likes them because they are chirpy, talking all over the place. So this uncle of him is very fond of him, and he says, "Achha, bimar lag gaya, theek, abhi dekho X-ray nikalte hain, dekho yahan fracture hai, abhi patti lagani padegi, plaster lagana padega, 6 hafte." So he teaches him everything, and he knows about 6 different fractures. All of them are accident prone. They put themselves and others in embarrassing situation, and they end up breaking things without such intention. Their intentions are not bad. We asked Imran also. Yes, what he wants to be. Absolutely. He wants to also to be orthopedic surgeon. He says, mujhe malum hai sab fracture ke bare mein malum hai, mujhe padhai ki zarurat hi nahi hai, main orthopedic surgeon ban jaunga.
Padhai ki zarurat nahi hai.
Okay. I have an unsolicited advice for all of you who are planning to work with this children. As I said, they are not interested in what you are going to ask them. कौन से स्कूल में जाते हो, कौन से सब्जेक्ट है, not interested. He will not establish any rapport with him. If you want to establish a rapport with him, then you have to talk about Spider-Man. You say, आपको Spider-Man अच्छा लगता है? हाँ, Spider-Man मेरा भी फेवरेट है, तुम्हारा भी फेवरेट. Let's talk about Spider-Man. So if you want to establish rapport with these children, start watching Cartoon Network films. Whenever you are free, वो आप शाम को देख रहे हो ये रिश्ता क्या कहलाता है, या तो कहाँ हम कहाँ तुम, suppose you are watching that, उसमें बीच में एडवर्टाइज आते हैं, and advertisement you shift and say, अभी कौन सा कार्टून नेटवर्क चल रहा है. If there are very small young children, they like Pingu the penguin. Very nice. Coo coo coo, coo coo coo, 2 minutes and over. Then you have Bobby,
Bob the builder,
Noddy, Bal Hanuman.
They like Hanuman.
Jai Bhim, and the most famous and notorious Shin Chan, my favorite. So basically, I think we all can now very very easily identify these children. They can have either only attention deficit disorder, that means बच्चा शांत है क्लास में बैठता है पर ध्यान short attention span, only 5 to 10 minutes he can pay attention and then he goes into that screen saver mode. So then we call them attention deficit disorder, difficult to identify because they are not disturbing the class. And the second group is ADHD, attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, that means chanchal bachche, class mein baithte nahi hai, dhamal karte hain, masti karte hain, they are easy to identify. And in each class I am sure you will have one or two children who are ADHD. So in any class, if you see, it is more common in boys like any other disorder. ADHD is more common in boys, and almost 2 to 4%, I would put it as 5% of the children. So if you have a class of 50, you will have 2 children in each class who will be hyperactive. And remember these 3 cardinal symptoms, the most important symptoms: inattentiveness, where they have a short attention span and easy distractibility; hyperactivity, that is indulging in aimless, purposeless, non-goal directed activities. You will enter this room, start walking, climb on the chair, jump, take a water bottle and sprinkle water. Why are you doing it? No reason. Whatever comes to his mind at that particular point, he will do it. And impulsivity, indulging in activities without thinking about its consequences. Called ADHD, attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. And variety of these children who have ADHD are referred to us, and we treat them. Treatment includes 2 things: counseling, occupational therapy, and medicines. We have very effective medicines. Methylphenidate is one of the most effective medicine which is available. And you give this medicine in the morning before going to school, and for 6 to 8 hours or 10 hours, the child has very good attention span. He sits quietly. He is attentive. And his all overall performance improves. So I think there I would like to end the first topic of ADHD. If you have any questions, we can take it quickly and then go on to second. Okay. SK. Okay. So in the first part of my lecture, we talked about ADHD, chanchal bachche. The second part is ziddi bachche, oppositional and defiant disorder.